before all the hype shit, let's talk about a couple plays that I talked about in the last video that I've been in, that I've been holding, chilling on. Because look at Peanut, bro. It's been out for 2 weeks and it's at $2 billion market cap, bro. I was telling you guys at 97 million. I just want to give you guys a little update because I definitely took some profit off the table and I want to show you guys how I took that profit. Tight shit. So whatever, you guys see my sales right here. This is the hour chart though. Remember, it was just going up so crazy. I was just taking little bits off the top type shit. But I think I still got 4K, 4.3K in this bitch, right? But overall, you know, overall P&L, we're almost at 9,000, which is cool. But dude, this is going to be insane. If you guys aren't in Peanut yet, I don't know if it's going to dip again. But if this shit hit 2 billion in 2 weeks, what do you think it's going to do when everything goes parabolic again? Not telling you the top blast. You buy right now, it's going to be a top blast. But update number one, I want to show you this real quick. Nom Nom. Like I told you guys in the last video, bro, I put 10 soul in. How much is that? Like, what, $2,200? I think, what, spike to, I thought it spiked to like 70, maybe over here. Nah, not even. Whatever. So it spiked to about 60 mil, whatever. Huge sell-off. You got to take your profits, bro. So I absolutely understand it. Today we saw somebody put in a $100,000 buy into this bitch. Yeah, Nom Nom to me is like easy. But that's a hold, bro. You know, if you're trying to go in there, trade it real quick, might not be the best play for that. But yeah, I'm patiently holding. I'd rather hold 10 soul and Nom Nom than 10 soul just in general. You know, the return is for me and I'm holding. I mean, not telling you guys what to buy, what to sell, whoop de whoop. But I made a video on this shit. So I wanted to show you, you know, where we're still standing. Like I said, I'm not selling. Dude, it's just too bullish, honestly. So next one real quick, Fred. This is another one that we talked about on stream. This went fucking stupid. Got to take some off the table. So my current position, I only put 2 soul, bro. Dude, it's late, you know. That's why I had to drop 10 soul on Nom Nom, because I should have been doing that with these plays, you know. Who cares? 2 soul, which is what, $400 in. We're up a little 3K. Secured a good profit. You guys see the numbers. It is what it is. It's really just those three, honestly. Oh no, then this one as well. Gato, because this one also was kind of shitting the bed. Let me show you my trades. I was buying low. I mean, you guys were all here. We did this shit on stream, right? But let me show you the return. We made, what, $800? Oh no, $600 on my bed. But I still got a small bag in there. I just saw it go, you know, just continue to dive. Said, do you share all those trades on TG? I mostly share them all alive type thing. I think I did all these plays on live. I'm not the one to just send a call. You know what I'm saying? When I do, I mean business, I stand behind it, but I'm not the one to just send a call, because to me, not that it's sus or sketchy by any means. I think it's just a little bit more genuine if I jump on live and just show you guys what I'm buying. You know, it's just straight up. Bro said, congrats, you different. I spent a lot of money joining these shit alpha groups. The value provided is different. Hey, appreciate you, gang. And we're cooking stupid for this 10K drop, bro. Spending some bread so we can put everything all together. So the new people, the people that have been joining every other alpha group type shit, come through, print. This could be something. Should we throw something in? I might get a bid in this. 200K in volume, not too bad. Is that a good dip right now too? I think I might throw a soul in just to start. It's still kind of active on Twitter. Yeah, Poly, it's not looking too bad, bro. I did get into it. Oh, this one's sending. This one's going stupid. Damn, what do you think? Do I put $400 into Mike's ass? Do I put $400 into Mike's ass? Because he just showed his ass? Or was that retarded? Well, it's retarded, obviously, but I feel like I got to, bro. Nigga said throwing bread at a male stripper. That's tough. All right, let's see if I can get it. Okay. All right, I got mevved. Oh. Hold up. That's where I'm at. I'll get in again. Someone just put in 43 soul. I only threw in one soul. Hoping that it'll come down a little bit more, but it's tough. Which one? This is the one at 1 million in volume in the last 5 minutes at, 300K. All right. And this one I put in an order. We're going to let it cook. Let's see what's going on over here. Yeah, the holders are going stupid on this one. Jesus, bruh. Jesus. Yeah, these holders are going up stupid, bruh. And if he comes out, with his ass cheeks hanging, yeah, this is gonna send. Dude, yeah, this mic coin is going stupid. Like, should have put a little more in, but it's all Gucci. I plan to send, or I'm gonna sell Mike once I see his walkout. If I see him walking out with some booty shorts on, like, you know, holes in the cheeks, I'm gonna hold it type thing. But if I don't, then I'll probably end up getting out of it. Well, it's just an outfit, right? Oh, nigga. Oh, my God, bro. That might be his fit. Dude, if he walks out with that as his fit, well, we're up at least. I mean, what's this? That's like a 2X real quick. Oh, my God. Yeah. Oh, shit. That was a huge. Damn, what the hell is that? 57, so. Yeah, we're pushing a 3X on this bitch. That's a quick 400. I mean, if I were to sell, this is definitely the dumbest money I probably have ever made, for real. Out of all the meme coins I've ever traded, one of the dumbest shits ever. And I only put in one soul. That's crazy. Still has 1 million volume in the last 5 minutes, bro. This Mike Tyson just went to 1.5 mil, 1.4. Bro. We're up $900.
Oh, nah.
Do you see it?
Oh, nah.
Light skin, handsome. Oh, my God. This. Did you see that shit? Dude.
Oh, nah.
Yeah, that shit dirty. Right. Oh, my bad. Look, we're over here fucking. I'm over here looking at this or watching this fight and shit. And, bro, we just made a band. That's a quick bando. Tight shit. And see, I'm going to wait real quick until, I'm going to wait until Mike Tyson comes up on the stage. Because I swear to God, if Mike Tyson walks out, cheeks swinging in the wind, bro, this is going to send. This absolutely will send. Look at it go, bro. And look, one of our whale walls just bought Pico Top. 1 mil. Look at this. Come on, gang. This is a beautiful 10K subscriber special, for real. Here go my trades. Get the track wallets out. There we go. I mean, just because bro wanted to see it. One buy. I wish I would have bought more. It'd be like that. Who gives a fuck? What can I do? Yeah, whatever. Selling tops. You just got, bro, just sell the tops. But we're not full clipping tops, bro. Just, you know, take some off the top. That's it. Bro, what I can see is us printing on the fucking this Mike Tyson's cheek coin. Look at it. I'm just taking, you know, skimming some off the top. Do it. Maybe go up a little bit more. See, we're just selling like little bits at a time. And I think it helped us out and sold at the top again. Sheesh. Let's go. Look at that. I'm going to clip another 25%. Why? Because, dude, charts just don't go up forever. I wish they did, but nah, gang. Buy the rumor, sell the news. Bro, ask if we should trade the Mike Tyson the coins. Look, if someone gets knocked out, there will be absolute like another sender. If other party has, you know, his cheeks out just like Mike Tyson, that's another sender. All right, yo. Fuck Jake Paul, bruh. Mike Tyson's walkout is all we're looking for. For real, for real. Ass is not out. Aw, no ass cheeks. Pause. elder abuse. This one could be tough. Elder abuse. I want a good. Oh fuck! I wanted a good dip. I'm trying to get like a little soul in that thing. If it could dip a lot more on this this elder abuse coin, and if it does, that's where I get more in, of course. But I would love to get a better price, a little bit, give me a bigger dip. Fuck, I need a better dip. Come on, gang, give me some more. Fuck. All right, elder abuse is sending, bro. Elder abuse is. This one's looking good. Oh, this is looking good, good. Why the fuck do I keep going pussy-ass amounts, bro? Fuck. If it dips below my average. Oh, shit. All right. We made a good amount that first play. Let's check out the second play right here. And I like this elder abuse coin because it's like a, it's a good like overall kind of meme. You know what I'm saying? All right. Well, we're over 2x already. Quick little 2x on this elder. I'm looking at the holders right here because it's kind of slowing down already, bro. If it continues to slow, like volume wise and holders wise, I'm gonna start, you know, clipping. Okay, now it's going. Huh. Just want to make sure you get a little bit out. Another sender, bruh. Come on, gang. Yeah. Let's go. Sheesh, bruh. Nigga. You know, clip a little at the that Pico top right there. Yeah. That's it. Let it keep going. It just went up over 100 holders. We're about to hit 200 holders. Yeah. Another sender, bro. 500 profit. All right, now. Slowing down a little bit. Take a little bit off the top. Tyson might turn up here in a second. Oh, shit. I think this elder abuse still has good potential, though, for real. And that shit will go crazy if he gets beat down. Oh, my God. Look at that send. Look at this send. Whoa. Whoa. Whoa, that was. Whoa. Whoa. Let's go. That's another million coin. That's another million coin. Every round Jake Paul wins, elder abuse is gonna go up. Shit. Damn. This nigga cannot get knocked out, bro. I swear to God. This nigga Mike cannot get knocked out. Please, nigga. I genuinely feel like if Jake Paul wins, which he might, he really might. This shit could still go. Like, the other one already died. I think, didn't Mike's ass already die in that shit? Oh, no. Wow, that shit actually chilling. At 600K. He said, EA dead. Yeah, it's looking pretty dead. It could come back, though, but who knows? That's why you gotta take your profits at the top. Only reason I could see this EA come back is because, you know, that nigga lost. But I got my moon bag in that bitch still. It is. Oh, this shit out of there. Yeah, EA out of there. Amazing group of people. And it's just an honor to be in the ring with all of them. Did you try to knock him out? Man, I was. Let's see what we made. 1.18. Oh, no, K. 1.18K. And whatever. And then 3. All right, smooth. So about $1,400 tonight during this fight shit. Not too bad. This shit is fucking beautiful. And look, this is an example of how I sell. I'm not telling y'all how to sell, just me. That shit continues to go up. 25% clips, you know, 25, some were 10, 15. How you get into coins so early and give your take on the fight for real? Getting in coins early, personally, it's just knowing what to look for. And then when you find it, there's no reason why you would sell, if that makes sense. You know, if you have enough conviction, if you believe in it enough, you don't even think about selling. You know what I'm saying? Like down here, I was buying at 97 million. I already explained all this shit, but yeah, you start bidding for a reason. That's it. P&L on nothing crazy. It's like, yeah, it's nothing crazy. If I would have held it, you know, we would definitely be up a lot more, but you got to secure your profits, bro. I still got like 20 soul on that bitch. We're up like almost, you know, 8.5K. We've been in the trenches for a long time, so buying at 97 million like Peanut, buying at 16 million like Fred here, I wouldn't do that before. However, $100,000 market cap is now like the new $1 million market cap. It's just insane. Half a mil. Wow, this is sending crazy, actually. When you see that volume that's like stupid like that. Oh, look at all those snipers at the top holders. That's dangerous. Threw a little half solo in just in case. Yeah, I actually might not be in this play for too long. Yeah, I'm just not trying to get farmed on that bitch. I don't like all those snipers, bro. That's 14% held by a sniper. It's like, I don't know. Like, it's a little much for me, nigga. You know what I'm saying? He said, what do you do with all your money low-key? Do you got like 3 Lambos and a mansion? I said it before, but only on some live streams. The profits that come from trading, I roll those into my long-term holds. The more utility plays, wealth creation plays kind of thing. Roll those over and then, you know, ask me at the end of the bull run or, you know, when shit starts to cool off, what I'm doing with the profits then. But I think that's, I recommend people to do that as well. And people really don't even have any type of long-term holds. Like, I'm talking like 6 to 12 months, not like fucking, you know, 10 years. Y'all watching me sit here and watch this bitch, for real. I hit 2 plays already, so, you know, I'm not gonna force it, you know what I'm saying? Ain't no, oh my God, look at that shit go. Look at that shit, like, that's not how charts usually work, you know what I'm saying? Like, typically it goes up and it comes down like that, you know, a little bit, instead of going way back up again. Fuck.
Okay, Mr. 10K. Okay.
Fuck.
Mr. 10K in the building.
Should I inch my way into the play? Oh, fuck, man. Let me inch my way, all right? You know what I'm saying? That's my average cost. The Sergio shit looking a little iffy. Real quick, yeah, the Sergio shit, you can see it's dipping. The volume is actually not too bad. No kizzy. Well, it's actually fire. 1,000 holders. How much money did I put in? $50. $55. Why? Damn. All right, cool. All right, why did I put in 50? Because I wanted to DCA into the play. So there's dollar cost average into it. I don't want to put... You know, if I wanted to put a full Solana into the bitch, I didn't want to do it in one clip. However, I'm not going to continue to buy it forever, nigga, because this shit could just dip and die. So we're going to let that cook, see what happens. Bro said, 3 tips I would give to a newbie. 3 tips. 1, take profit. You didn't make any money until you slow. That's it. All right, let's look for the next one, but that's the first one. Because like this right here, let me take a little profit. Listen to people that are doing what you want to do. Don't just listen to anybody, you know. Look at the track record. 3, don't emotionally trade. The second you start getting hurt, you start rage trading. Say bye to your bread.
I would say 1, and everything I say is coming from this nigga for sure. 1, I would say research. Research on the play that you trying to trade. 2, I would say don't rush. If you fuck around, and that kind of ties into his emotional one, You rush, you emotional, you like what you see too much, you could get fucking blown out. You get blown out the water type shit. Niggas will really fucking rug your shit. And number three, take profits type shit.
So what was the first one again?
Research.
Research. Diligence. Deal diligence. Cool. Number two,
don't rush. Yep.
Don't force a trade. Beautiful. And number three,
take profits.
Take profits. That's solid as fuck. For real.
Type shit.
Good shit, gang. Look at that nigga. He said,
I was just about to say, he said that right as you said that.
This nigga said, taking profits equals strategic GD. Beautiful.
Oh, God.
There's nothing wrong with saying, lovely, lovely, gang.